So I want you all to imagine a future where technology works hand in hand with sustainability. Now, what does that mean? For example, let's say we are doing something out of technology and we are creating an impact simultaneously. Wow, what a wonderful world. Are you imagining? Or are you imagining, like, you're imagining, right? Okay, so now this is what my talk's gonna be all about. How AI can contribute effectively to sustainable development goals. You might have heard about sustainable development goals. Everyone? Yes. If you haven't, I'll just tell you what are sustainable development goals. But before that, I'll just give you a brief overview of what my journey has been. So I have been one of the persons like who was born and brought up in some climatic conditions. I've seen people living in drought areas because I was also one of them, right? So when I went into National Institute of Technology, one thing which eventually came to my mind was that why can't we integrate technology with sustainability? And that was the thing which eventually clicked my mind, and I was like, I have to do this. I started creating impact on ground. I started working on climate change. I started doing tree plantations and beach cleanups. But then AI was the thing which excited me, and it excited me like some 5 years back. I know AI boom is going on. But then I just wanted to tell you one thing. What are SDGs? Let's try and understand what are SDGs. SDGs are sustainable development goals, everyone knows. Now, if I want to categorize SDGs, I'll categorize it into three ways: economic, environmental, and social. So I just need all of you to engage in like one thing. Just tell me, I think you can talk also. What do you think is economic, environmental, and social SDGs? So I'll just show you one by one. Okay. What do you think? Economic, environmental, social? You understand economic, right? Environmental, social. What is this? Social, okay. Social? Good wealth? Good health? Social? Okay. Quality education. There are 17 sustainable development goals, by the way. This is social. What do you think? Economic, environmental, social? That's fine, guys. Just be a bit louder. What do you think? Social, okay. Gender equality? Okay. Clean water and sanitation? I'll give you the answers. That's fine. Okay. Affordable and clean energy? Okay. Decent work and economic growth? Environmental, social, economic? Okay. There are people mix economic and social, okay. Industry? Industry, innovation, and infrastructure. What do you think? Okay. And what about this one? Reduced inequalities. So, okay. Let's see. Sustainable cities and communities? Okay. Responsible consumption and production. Environmental? How many of you say environmental? Okay. Climate action? Oh my God, like this is the easiest one, right? Okay. Life below water? Okay. Life on land? Let's see. Peace, justice, and strong institutions. And the last one? Partnership for the goals. So now, you know economic, environmental, and social. All the ones which are having orange boundary, they are social. Okay. I was just playing. All the ones which are having blue boundary, they are economic. And all the ones in the green are environmental. You can see how wrong you are. But I just wanted to tell you that even United Nations had set this framework that we are focused on economic, environmental, and social. So now how AI comes. What is... Okay, let's see. So what is AI? I wanted to say Amboli and I, right? The love between Amboli and I, but it's not, right? So AI is artificial intelligence. What is artificial intelligence? Basically, we are trying to train machines so that they can try to understand humans and even go beyond our intelligence, right? That is artificial intelligence. So if you see, what is missing? There are two things which are missing. These all SDGs are, they are interconnected. You cannot work on one SDG and you say, okay, I'll make sure that, you know, quality education is good. You have to make sure that other SDGs which are interconnected, they're also working. Second thing is, okay, which I feel is scalability. Now, the change which you are making in Belagavi, if you want to implement the same change across India, that has to be scalable. That is like one of the most important things. So now, how AI can help SDGs? One stat says AI could help achieve 79% of the sustainable development goals. We don't think about that. Definitely, there are a lot of things, but AI is also the one. So now, see, these are the societal outcomes. Transition to a zero carbon economy. What will happen? If we start integrating AI with sustainability, we might move towards a zero carbon economy. We'll also increase the agricultural efficiency. For example, you have heard about predictive analysis? Have you heard about Siri? Siri, everyone, Siri? Apple Siri, wake me up at 7 a.m. in the morning? Yes? Siri is an AI, you know that, right? What it does three things. It does NLP, which is natural language processing. It actually listens to you and try to understand what are you saying. Okay, so we talk to our friends like, "Arey, mujhe 7 baje utha dena." But when you're talking with Siri, "Wake me up at 7 a.m. in the morning." Why? Because we want Siri to understand us, right? That is natural language processing. There's a predictive analytics also going on. That she understands what we're trying to say. So that's where increasing agricultural efficiency is. We try to understand what kind of crops are suited for what kind of fields. And that's where we are trying to increase the yield based on the weather patterns using AI. Third thing is fighting poverty. So we are supposed, we can also fight poverty. Why? We can increase the crop yield, and once the crop yield is increased, we can try to understand that what kind of crops are suitable, and that's where we can increase the crop yields. And the last one is fraud detection. I'll just give you an example. There are economic outcomes as well. How many of you think job creation can be done by AI? Many of you are against it. Some of you might be against AI as well. Something job loss is there. But you should also understand job creation is also there. How? Basically, AI is demanding skilled labor. That's fine, right? So now, as AI comes into the picture, people are having more skills and they'll start understanding that why AI is important, right? So that's why skilled job creation is something which you can see 5 years down the line. You'll start people understanding more skills are coming in the market, people are trying to adapt to the technology better. And the final thing is environmental outcomes. So if you see environmental preservation, have you heard about climate action, right? Climate change, we all talk about that. Now the thing is, with the help of AI, we can try to understand the weather patterns, and then what we can do is, we can try to implement the things in different parts of the world to make sure that people are not getting interrupted by the floods and all that stuff. So we try to save the people from drought areas. Okay, I'll give you some examples real time. Healthcare AI. Have you heard about this? In COVID-19 times, I worked on like one particular system where I created, with the help of Google Cloud's Dialogflow, one healthcare AI system wherein an individual and doctor can talk together without being in any physical touch, because that was the demand of the COVID. How is it possible? It is possible only because of AI. I'll give you one more example. If you can see this one, basically you can segregate the waste. Waste management is a thing, right? So AI can eventually help you to segregate this if you can see the boxes, right? So on the boxes, you can try and understand that these boxes are telling you that what waste is of what type. So you can segregate it and machines can segregate it. There are a couple of more, mining detection through the satellites, email classification. So basically, if you're getting like some 10,000 emails, you can classify it with the help of AI. Now, what is next? I was thinking I had to incorporate miles to go before I sleep, so I have created a road. Okay, so now what is something which is next? Let's actually start the journey together. Now, what is this journey? This journey is about educating each other, and I feel AI is something which is going to be very important. So we should try and understand what AI is, and we should try and teach other people what AI is. So learn and educate, but we should also focus on responsible AI. Now, what is responsible AI? AI is not something which is trying, we should create some system which is trying to demean someone. We should try to create a responsible AI which is also creating impact simultaneously. And then we should lead to a sustainable future. So these are the things which eventually I am trying to achieve on the road of AI to SDGs. And I feel with all of you, it's not like miles to go before I sleep is there. But I also wish that there are miles to go before you sleep. Miles to go before we all sleep, right? So thank you so much for that, everyone. Thank you.